Monitoring is an important aspect of any application, but for a mission-critical workload, it becomes crucial. By keeping an eye on key metrics emitted by Azure resources, you can understand if everything is working as expected. However, interpreting these metrics to estimate the impact on the overall solution requires a holistic understanding of the workload. A health model can help with these challenges as it reflects a quantified health status, rather than raw metrics. The status is often presented through traffic light indicators. Start by calculating the health status of each component by using collected metrics and application telemetry. Always evaluate the metrics with knowledge of the expected operating circumstances to produce an overall health score. Let's say your API endpoint is considered to be healthy when average response times are under 200 milliseconds while CPU utilization stays below 75%, and the exception counter remains at zero. If either of those thresholds is exceeded, the health state and score will become degraded and get reflected by a change in status. Think of a health model as a hierarchy, just like a dependency graph. The graph nodes represent both the Azure resources and the dependent application components. The top-level nodes represent the user or system flows for business scenarios. The bottom nodes indicate the low-level platform dependencies. The health score of a user flow captures key business requirements as measurements to provide a meaningful business view of health. If a node turns yellow or red, then it is likely the node above will also. This representation makes it intuitive for an operator to understand overall health and the impact of issues, allowing them to respond quickly. Health modeling can be, and should be, an exhaustive exercise. Check out these resources and get started on your journey toward a well-architected, mission-critical solution.